in terms of happiness, people try to get it from the outside. What about personal unhappiness? So many things which are not other people's responsibility or are not other people's due in life, they might get infected to it simply because we might not be able to contain personal unhappiness. I was so self-absorbed in my own journey that I would pull people into it, because the sad thing which we see in the world today, which in my opinion is like an age of anxiety and insecurity. Namaste everyone, how's it going? So, just wanted to share something because Ayan and I were having a conversation. I have just returned to work after a while, so like we were just catching up. And we were talking about something which recently also struck me, that it had cost me a lot in terms of my personal life. And I thought I want to share it. I don't know where this will go. But I wanted to talk about personal unhappiness. Because so many people talk about happiness, but there is no happiness if there is no sadness. So that is an integral part of life and it will never go away. No matter how much we try to make our lives happy, the whole point of human existence is that suffering and disappointment are there along the way, regardless of what we might strive for, no matter how evolved we try to become, no matter how woke we are, suffering and unhappiness are part of the process. So a lot of people will love to talk about how to be happy or how to have happiness in our life, how to be a positive person. That's all beautiful. But by the sheer nature of being human, there will be days when we feel hurt. There will be days when we feel angry. There will be days when we feel upset. There will be days where we feel jealous. There will be days where we can't see other people happy. But now that I've just put perspective onto the reality that there will be unhappiness no matter how amazing we might become, I want to talk about, okay, what to do with it. Because I just want to share what I noticed in hindsight, because in hindsight our vision is 2020, right? Like we are able to judge our past much better because now we have come through it, and now we look at, okay, you know, maybe I should have taken another decision or this or that. But here simply what I'm going to talk about is containment of personal unhappiness. Because the sad thing which we see in the world today, which in my opinion is like an age of anxiety and insecurity, is that we all know that in terms of happiness, people try to get it from the outside, whether it is accumulating social media numbers, whether it is accumulating money, whether it is accumulating materials, whether it is accumulating even spiritual ego or whatever it is. But what about personal unhappiness? If we know that this shouldn't be taken from the outside, happiness, the same way personal unhappiness should not be given outside. Because I realized that sometimes, like for me being quite strong and individual, I was so self-absorbed in my own journey that I would pull people into it. I would pull my own into it, family into it, etc. Which is again normal, human, etc. But so many things which are not other people's responsibility or are not other people's due in life, they might get infected to it simply because we might not be able to contain personal unhappiness. And that is why I wanted to talk about it today, because as briefly as I can, I wanted to share the message that when we are personally unhappy, either we should learn how to manage it, you know, because it's not unavoidable. There will be phases. So self-management, self-sufficiency, which has been like for the Freeman Brotherhood in terms of a Pune meetup, the entire meetup was around the theme of self-sufficiency, because simply the nature of questions after 2020 for people were just all related to self-regulation of emotions and everything. So being self-sufficient when it comes to personal unhappiness means that either we learn how to resolve it ourselves, or if we can't resolve it, at least we don't let it come on out onto the other people around us. Because unfortunately, what happens is that the people we should be cherishing the most, loved ones, family, closest people, they end up taking the brunt of each other's unhappiness. That is why we have community, that is why we have family for Saath and Sahara, support and company. That is all fine, but what happens is that sometimes we might end up taking them for granted and we might end up simply continuously letting our personal unhappiness go out more and more, more and more, more and more, to the level where people who deserve our attention, deserve our love, deserve that we should be able to keep our personal unhappiness aside, and when we go to interact with them, whether it is our parents or whether it is our partner or whether it is our brother or sister, that we are able to go to them also in this day also with a smile on our face. Because if we think about it, weaker as we are, today's generation compared to our parents, we love to bitch and moan and whine, and obviously on social media post that I'm depressed and everything, which is all fantastic, right? More power to you. But is it required?